Built by 64 generation of kings, the temple sits on 16 acres of land. This massive structure has 4,500 pillars and 14 towers, covered with 33,000 figures of brightly painted gods, demons and animals in vivid colors. Welcome to Meenakshi Amman Temple, the pride of Madurai. The ancient city of Madurai, often referred to as Mathura of South. It is famous for Meenakshi Amman Temple, its center located near the bank of Vegai River. Kulashekar Pandyan, the grandfather of Queen Meenakshi, constructed a small temple with a Shivlingam in the 1st century CE. On the ceiling between the Meenakshi and Sundareshwar sanctum is the rotating Lingam painting. The painting is centuries old and is being repainted every 12 years to look new. No matter which angle you see this Lingam from, you will see that the spout at the base always point towards you. The temple was further expanded by many generations of Pandyan kings by clearing the forest of Kadamba trees. Muslim invader Malik Kafur partially destroyed the temple in 1310 AD. The temple was rebuilt by Vishwanath Nayak in accordance with the principles laid down in the Shilp Shastra. The temple is designed based on the human body. It has four towers facing in all four directions and five main entrances based on human body senses: see, hear, smell, taste and touch. There are nine smaller entrances to inside complex that denotes nine orifices of human body: to eyes, to nostrils, to ears, mouth, urethra and anus. The northern tower is the left hand. The eastern tower is the legs. It is the oldest tower. The southern tower is the right hand. It is the tallest tower. The western tower is the human head. The central area of the temple is the chest. The pond is the abdomen area. The reigning deity of the temple, Goddess Meenakshi in the form of Parvati, is one eye, and Lord Sundareshwar in the form of Shiva is the other eye. Inside the Garbhagriha stands the goddess Meenakshi carved from a single emerald stone. What entices me was her diamond nose ring dazzles in the glow of the oil lamps. Goddess Meenakshi is the principal deity of the temple. She blesses the people with her eyes, and that is why Madura is called as the city that never sleeps. North of Goddess Meenakshi chamber resides her consort Lord Sundareshwar, surrounded by a hall containing pillars embellished with carvings. 25 forms of Lord Shiva are shown here. But the most famous of this is the depiction of wedding scene of Goddess Meenakshi Lord Sundareshwar followed by Meenakshi's brother Lord Vishnu. Minute carvings of fingers and hands of three figures is really a wonder in stone. Madurai Meenakshi Temple is one of the 64 Shakti Kendra. Here Lord Shiva performed 64 miracles to save his devotees, which can be seen on the walls surrounding the pond. Lord Indra came to Madurai to worship Lord Shiva because he did a misdeed and he wanted to redeem himself. To redeem himself, he wanted to offer 1,000 flowers. He plucked 999 flowers out of the pond and had no more. He prayed to God for one more flower. And a golden flower appeared from the pond. That is why the pond is called Potramarai Kulam, meaning pond of golden flower. As one enters through the eastern gateway, there is a hall called Meenakshi Nayakar Mandapam. It has sculptures on pillars which depicts the story of Meenakshi's birth and her life as the princess of Madurai. The story described on the stone is as follows. Malayadvaja Pandya, a king of Madurai, was childless and the god blessed him with a daughter who was born from a pit of fire. The girl grew into a brave and beautiful princess. That princess was called Tada Tagai, more popularly known as Meenakshi, as her eyes were like a fish. She fought many battles but eventually fell in love with Lord Shiva when she met him on the battlefield in Kailash. There she realized that she was the incarnation of Goddess Parvati. After ruling over the Pandya kingdom for a while, they settled in the Madurai temple as Meenakshi and Sundareshwar. One of the highlights at Meenakshi temple which you should not miss is the night ceremony. Every night an image of Lord Shiva is carried out from his shrine in procession in a chariot to his wife Meenakshi's shrine where he will spend the night. Lord Sundareshwar gold feet are brought from his shrine while his chariot is fanned to keep it cool. And a puja is performed amidst much chanting, drums and horns. The Meenakshi temple hosts a festival in each month of the Tamil calendar. But the most important festival is the Chithirai festival, which falls in the month of April-May and lasts for over 30 days. It marks the divine marriage of Goddess Meenakshi with Lord Sundareshwar. The festival includes a procession where Meenakshi and Sundareshwar travel in a chariot pulled by volunteer devotees. And Lord Vishnu gives away his sister in marriage to Lord Shiva. Apart from religious spot to visit, Madura is famous for its super cold drink Jigar Thanda, packed with all the benefits of Badam Peshin, Nanari syrup, etc. And if you are at Madura, don't forget to try it at famous Jigar Thanda located at the East Marriott Street. Shopping at Madura is one of the experiences that is absolutely worth having. Famous for its handicraft items, bangles and batik sarees, Madura has it all.